around him were as well. There was a promise of not being too burdened by the past.
John F. Kennedy settles into office as the 35th President of the United States, the youngest man and the first Roman Catholic ever elected to the office. The first president born in the 20th century. He comes to office after one of the narrowest elections in American history.
Americans had chosen their leader as much for his glamour and energy as for the substance of his policies. They had chosen him in their own image, a young country on the move. The road ahead promised a new era of economic growth and social harmony.
Let the word go forth from this time and place to friend and foe alike that the torch has been passed to a new generation of Americans born in this century, tempered by war, disciplined by a hard and bitter peace, proud of our ancient heritage, and unwilling to witness or permit the slow undoing of those human rights to which this nation has always been committed.
After only 1,000 days of life on Kennedy's new frontier, Americans would long for what seemed to them simpler times, the 1950s.
My friend.
There's an old saying that the 4th of July is not now and never was what it used to be, and there's a tendency to romanticize the 50s and to forget the narrowness, the prejudice, but I think there's a generally far greater freedom and a sense of possibility, economic and other, today than in the past.
And what's important about the 50s is that everybody opened their eyes up and learned to see pictures and take pictures seriously. It's the most visual decade in our history, and it made us who we are today.
We came to the conclusion that we were going to live for something or we were going to die for nothing.
The 50s, for me, were a time of tremendous change and promise, where it felt that just a few people maybe could sort of change the world.
In our love of everything new and modern, a lot of wonderful old things got torn down to make way for new parking lots, new shopping malls. And exciting as that might have been, I mean, a lot was lost as well.
The legacy was a legacy of hope and dreams. So those of my generation still carry those hopes and dreams. I'm not sure that our children care them nearly as enthusiastically as we did.
There'll never be another 50s. It is the most influential thing, and it wasn't by accident. The time was ready. We delivered the goods.
At the end of my